Assalamu alaikum students, hope all of you are fine and doing well at your home. It's me, your Islamic studies teacher, Ghazala. Today I am going to revise Surah Al-Lahab and Surah Al-Maun. First, I'll tell you the theme of Surah Al-Maun. The theme of this surah is to point out what kind of morals a man develops when he refuses to believe in the hereafter. In verse number 2 to 3, the condition of the disbelievers who openly deny the hereafter is described. In the last 4 verses, the state of those hypocrites who apparently are Muslim but do not believe in the hereafter. The day of judgment, reward and the punishment has been described on the whole. The objective of deputizing the situation and conduct two kinds of people is to stress the point that man cannot develop a strong, stable and pure character in himself unless he believes in the hereafter. Those people who offer salah prayers but do not practice good behavior with other believers and neighbors and do not provide a helping hand when they are needed to do so have not understood the very reason for which congregational prayers are made obligatory. Therefore, it is pointed out that their prayers are nothing but a show and are not acceptable to the Allah. And such people may very well end up in their hell fire. So it is from this is from the Surah Al-Maun. Next, moving toward the Surah Al-Lahab. Surah Al-Lahab was revealed at Makkah during the period when Abu Lahab had transgressed all limit in his hostility to Prophet and his attitude was becoming a serious obstruction in the progress of Islam. What are the causes for the revelation of the Surah Al-Lahab is that Allah has cursed Abu Lahab and his wife who were the opponents of the Holy Prophet. And what is the theme of the Surah Al-Lahab is that this surah explains how Allah's curse will be applied to the Abu Lahab and his wife Umme Jamil for their evil behavior towards the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. It also shows the ultimate end of those who stand against Islam and against truth. This one is also the Makki Surah. It has 5 verses. The meaning of the title of the Surah is the flame. And the Surah Al-Lahab is taken from the 111th chapter of the Quran. So it's all from the Surah Al-Lahab. Student, you have to memorize both of the Surahs, Surah Al-Lahab and Surah Al-Maun, and after that, after learning and memorizing the surah, you have to fill the worksheet that I am going to provide you. So I pray to Allah for your health and safety. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.